Who am I that the Lord of all the earth would care to know my name, would care to feel my hurt? Who am I?
And now, my dear viewers, I want to welcome you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ to our program. Our program today is about shaking evil foundations. There are foundations which must be shaken, because foundations can be shaken. The Bible says that when Paul and Silas were in prison, the Bible says that the foundations were shaken as they prayed and they sang hymns unto God. God started shaking foundations. There was great earthquake, and that earthquake caused the foundations of the prison to be shaken. And the Bible says the chains which were in their hands and their feet, they broke, and the angel of the Lord delivered them. I welcome you, my dear viewer, today, and I declare unto you, as the foundations are shaken, you will come out of that captivity. You will come out of the prison in Jesus' name. Welcome, and go with me as we go through this message. God bless you. Amen. I would like to give a brief teaching about shaking evil foundations. Shaking evil foundations. I've talked about foundations before. I've said that foundations are made in the beginning. You cannot make a foundation at the end. Foundations are never seen. When you are building a foundation, you may not be seen. When you are building a foundation you are building may not be seen by men. Don't be surprised if you do something and nobody recognizes what you are doing. If you see you are doing something and it is not recognized, it is not seen, it is a foundational work you are doing. Praise God. And many times we become discouraged when you see you are doing something and nobody appear to appreciate, nobody appear to care, nobody appear to understand. Many times we are discouraged. Foundational builders are not recognized and they are not seen. Why? Foundations are not exposed. They go down. Praise the name of God. When other buildings are going up, when other structures are going up, foundations, they go down. Amen. So when you are dealing with the foundational problems, you are dealing with the problems which are deep inside. Deep. Where no man can see. There are problems you can have. If you tell people about them, nobody can understand you. Simply because by looking at you, you look okay. By looking at the way you are, you look okay. But there are issues. There are powers. There are problems you are dealing with that men cannot understand. It is important to understand the issues, the foundational problems. So I want to share about shaking evil foundation. Open together with me the book of Acts, chapter 16, verses 25 and 27. The Bible says, but at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners while listening to them. Suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of prisons were shaken. And immediately all the doors were open, and everyone's chains were broken. And the keeper of the prison, awakening from sleep, and seeing the prison doors open, supposing the prisoners had fled, drew his sword and was about to kill himself. Praise God. Praise God. There is very interesting things we can learn from this scripture. One of the things we see is that the foundations can be shaken. Hallelujah. The Bible says, in the middle of the night, they started praying. This is Paul and Silas. They started praying and singing hymns unto God. They started praying and singing hymns unto the Lord. And the Bible says, it was midnight. Hallelujah. Foundations are shaken by midnight prayers. Hallelujah. There are types of prayers called midnight prayers. Midnight is the highest level of darkness. It is the highest level of problems. It is highest level of no solution. They are called midnight prayers. If you can be able to pray in the midst of crisis, if you can be able to pray when prayers appear to have no answer, if you can be able to pray when nobody else is praying, if you can be able to pray when the dark is still and cold, when you are able to pray when nobody else is awake, at midnight majority of people are asleep. There is power in midnight prayers. Hallelujah. Lift up your hand. I just said, Lord, anoint me for midnight prayers. There is a night of a season. There is a night of the destiny. There is a night of career. There is a night of your business. There is a night of your family. A time when nobody seems to care. A time when no answer is being found. There are prayers which are called midnight prayers. You say, now I feel like not praying, but I'll pray. I feel that nobody else cares, but I will care. I feel that nobody is doing anything, but I will do something. This is the anointing and the grace of midnight prayer. The Bible says, and the foundations were shaken. I prophesy to you today, every foundation in your life will be shaken today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lift up your hand and say, foundations must be shaken. Shout louder, foundations must be shaken. The Bible says there were many prisoners in that prison. Hallelujah. There were many prisoners. It is not only Paul and Silas who are in the prison. There were other prisoners, the Bible says. But the others decided to move. Paul and Silas woke up. They started to rejoice when the chains are still in their feet. They decided to worship when the chains were still in their hand. And the Bible says they were praying and they were praising the Lord. And they were singing hymns. Hallelujah. Other prisoners decided to sleep. You can decide to worship and you can decide to praise. There is power in praising the Lord. There is power in worshiping the Lord. There is power in rejoicing in his presence. I don't know how you woke up this morning. Maybe you woke up in the wrong side of your bed. You woke up and you felt as if this day is not a day. Maybe you woke up and you felt like things did not happen the way you expected. You woke up in the midnight hour. But But I want to tell you, you can decide like Paul and Silas. They decided not to sleep like other prisoners. They decided to wake up. They decided to rejoice. They decided to dance. They decided to worship when the chains were still in their feet. Praise God. Lift up your head and say, I will praise and worship the Lord. The greatest thing you can do, my brother and my sister, is to decide to worship God, to rejoice in the Lord. Hallelujah. To celebrate the Lord in the midst of crisis. Praise the name of God. The Bible says, the prison had foundations. The Bible says, this prison where Paul was in, it had foundations. And the Bible says, there was a divine earthquake. Today I prophesy, there will be divine earthquake in your family. An earthquake that will shake the mountains. It will shake the rocks. It will shake the problem. It will shake your enemy. When the earthquake comes, it doesn't matter. Everything that is on the earth must be shaken. Praise God. Praise God. The Bible says, and there was a divine earthquake at the middle of the night. And the foundations of the prison, they were shaken. Praise God. And God commands earthquake to shake foundations when people commit themselves to prayer, commit themselves to sing and praise the Lord in the wrong hour of the night, at the wrong time of their lives. Hallelujah. Many times when we are in the problems, many times when things are not working, many times when people are against us, we don't have the spirit to rejoice. We don't have the spirit to stand and celebrate. We don't have the spirit. The greatest thing you can do when you are jobless is to dance. The greatest thing you can do when you have the enemies is to dance. The Bible says, he prepares a table for me in the presence of my enemies. Hallelujah. God will only prepare a table for you when the enemy is around. If the enemy is not present, know that there is no dish, there is no meal, there is no supper you can get from heaven. Hallelujah. God wait until he sees that you are surrounded by the enemies. And the Bible says, he prepares a table for me in the presence of my enemies. Lift up your hand and thank God because of your enemies. Thank God because of your enemies, because it is a key. It is something to show that God is preparing a table for you in the presence of your enemies. Today I declare in the name of Jesus Christ, your enemy will make you be celebrated. Your enemy will make God to celebrate your life in the name of Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Every hour is a dancing hour. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. May the spirit which was in Paul be in your life, my brother. May the spirit that was in Silas be upon your life, my sister. The Bible says they were put in the innermost prison of the day. The prison of the prisons. The chains were in their feet. Hallelujah. The chains were in their hands. But they decided to encounter the midnight prayers and the midnight worship and the midnight praising the Lord. I hear the Spirit tells me, in our midst, there are people who are in the midnight. There is a sister here who is in the midtime, in the midnight of the season, who is in the midnight of destiny, in the midst or in the midnight of business career, when everything looked dark and cold. I believe some of you people, you have come this morning here because you feel there is a midnight. There is a midnight hour in your life. There is a midnight hour in your marriage. There is a midnight hour in your business. There is a midnight hour in your family. But today I hear the Holy Spirit says the foundations are going to shake. Foundations are going to shake. Appreciate the Lord Jesus with a mighty hand. With a mighty hand. Hallelujah. Several things happen. The Bible this night, foundations of the prison was shaken. Several things happened this night. Number one, there was a divine earthquake. There will be divine earthquake in your life. Divine earthquake is not an earthquake that is brought by people. It is when heaven decides to shake the earth. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. When there is an earthquake, everything shakeable and unshakeable must be shaken. Today, God is shaking evil foundations in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, there are things that refuse to be shaken. There are problems which refuse to be shaken. There are things that refuse to be shaken. But I declare today, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, they'll be shaken today by the power of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ, they must be shaken today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Appreciate the Lord Jesus Christ with a mighty hand. Appreciate Jesus. Appreciate Jesus Christ. Appreciate Jesus Christ with a mighty hand. Hallelujah. There was an earthquake. And the Bible says the foundations of prison were shaken. That's something that happened that night. Foundations. Problems which you don't know where they started. Problems which you cannot see. Problems which have origin from the ancestors. Praise God. The Bible says foundations were shaken. Something else that happened that night. Something else that happened that night. The Bible says all doors were opened. Look at your Bible. Verse 26. Suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of prison were shaken, and immediately all doors were open. All doors. The Bible says all doors. Hallelujah. Business doors were open. Marriage doors were open. Hallelujah. 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 Witnessing doors were open. Healing doors were open. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Breakthrough doors were open. There is not a single door which was not opened that night. And I declare today in the name of Jesus Christ, every door, every stubborn door in your life must break in the name of Jesus Christ. Lift up your hand and say, my Father, my Father. Say louder by faith, my Father, my Father. In the name of Jesus, the name above every name, I declare and decree every stubborn door, every stubborn door in my family today, I command you in the name of Jesus, open by fire. Open by fire. Open your mouth. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. I see the doors opening. Today, God is releasing an earthquake that is going to shake the foundations of your problem. And every door will open. Will open up. It will open up. Yes, I declare. Whichever door you want to open, I declare, let it open today. Let it open today. Let it open today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Appreciate the Lord Jesus with a mighty hand. All doors were open. Not some. All doors. Sometimes we tend to think that there are doors that God can open, and there are doors which cannot be opened. I want to tell you today, for free. I want to tell you today, brethren, for free, that there is no door that God cannot open. I tell you that for free, free of charge. There is no door that God cannot open. There are some people who are crying here because of the midnight climate, because of the midnight darkness, because of the midnight loneliness, because of the midnight fears. But I am here as a prophet of God to declare unto you, there is no door that cannot be opened when there is a divine earthquake. May God unleash a divine earthquake today that will open your marital doors, that will open your future doors, that will open your business doors, that will open your family doors, that will open your children doors, in the name of Jesus Christ. Today there'll be an earthquake, and this earthquake will shake every problem, will shake every suffering, will shake every affliction and every torment in your life. Lift up your hand. Say, my Father, my Father. Say louder, my Father, my Father. In the name of Jesus, the name above every name, every stubborn door pursuing my life today, open by fire. In the name of Jesus, in the blood of Jesus Christ, give Jesus a mighty hand. And the Bible says, everyone's chains were broken. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Not only Paul and Silas. Amen. The people who were dancing and praising were two. Paul and Silas. They were only two. But the power in their praise, the power in their prayer, had ability to break the chains in the life of every prisoner who was in that prison. Praise God. Praise God. Everyone's chains were broken. Do you know, you can have a chain in your life. You can be bound by chains and you don't know. Hallelujah. There are different types of chains. There are economical chains. Hallelujah. There are character chains. There are spiritual chains. There are ancestral chains. There are financial chains. There are physical chains. Chains are spiritual. Spiritual chains are more dangerous than the physical ones. And today, I am here to say that it doesn't matter what type of a chain is operating in your life. It is breaking today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Don't tell me that your son is a drug trafficker. That is nothing before God. That is nothing. That is nothing. What you are calling a problem is nothing in the eyes of God. Today, I am declaring their chains, wherever they are, they are completely broken now. They are broken now. They are broken now. They are broken now. Every chain of the enemy upon your life, upon the life of your family, it is breaking. The Bible says, the prison keeper became powerless. Greet your neighbor and tell your neighbor, every prison has a prison keeper. Even if you break the door of the prison, unless you deal with the prison keeper, He will shoot you up there when you're trying to run away. Amen. The Bible says, and the prison keeper, there was a prison keeper, there was the chains. Hey, there was the chains, there was the door, and there was the prison keeper. Is it easy to come? It is impossible. And the Bible says they were in the prison of the prison. Walikuwa wamefungiwa kale kandani kabisa. Sio hii hapa mbele. Walikuwa wamepitishwa ya kwanza, ya pili, ya tatu, ya ine kule ndani. Wamefungwa miguu, wamefungwa mikono.
I do believe you have been blessed by the message of today. And as I come to conclude, I would like us to pray together with you, my dear viewer. The prayer I'm going to pray with you today is a prayer to shake foundations. I want you to believe the Lord together with me, wherever you are. Maybe you are there, you've been watching, and you know that there are foundations which are not right in your marriage. There are prisons which have swallowed your life. I want to destroy those foundations. Let's pray together. Mighty and everlasting Father, in the name of Jesus, the name above every name, I commit and dedicate my dear viewer unto you, O Lord. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, the foundations of evil are being destroyed now. You brought an earthquake and you delivered your servants. Today I call upon divine earthquake. Let the earthquake go to that family. I call upon earthquake in that business. Earthquake, let it come upon in that ministry. Let there be a mad earthquake in that marriage. I call upon earthquake in the life of my brother and my sister, where the enemy has put them in captivity, in that prison. In the mighty name of Jesus, I set them free. I break the evil foundations which have destroyed people for years. I break the foundations of darkness which have made people to cry and to suffer in the mighty name of Jesus. Every night I command it to turn into a day. Bring light in that life. Bring light in that marriage. Bring light in that body. Whoever is sick now, receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Whoever is being tormented by demons, receive your miracle in the name of Jesus Christ. Whoever is being under the attack of witches and powers of darkness, receive your healing in the mighty name of Jesus. I destroy all the enemies of truth, all the enemies of righteousness in Jesus' mighty name. I declare divine favor, divine power, and divine grace upon the children of God. Bless them and do them good in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I know you have been watching me. You have been watching this program Beyond Limitation. And now I am here to welcome you for another special program that we have prepared for all people from any denomination, from any corner of this nation. We are having a big conference that will start from the 27th of November, 2016. It will go all the way to 3rd of December, 2016. I want to welcome all of you. We are hosting you. We are hosting people here in Thika-Town. You can book. We are going to tell you about the details of this conference. The name of the conference is Mountain of Fire Conference. In this mountain, as you come, expect the fire of God to consume all your problems. Expect your body to be healed. Expect your marriage to be healed. Expect deliverance to take place in your life. Expect God to change your life forever. The presence of God will be mighty. Come to the Mountain of Fire Conference 2016. In Thika-Town, we are going to give you the details about the registration fee. We'll tell you the details about accommodation. You can come from Kericho, you can come from Mombasa, you can come from the Rift Valley, you can come from Kisumu. I'm inviting everybody to the Mountain of Fire Conference. This is a conference without any limit. We are going to see the glory of God. The power of God will land upon your life like thunder. You will see transformation. the grace of God will manifest in Jesus' mighty name. May you increase and multiply in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. God bless.